Greetings, I am Nathan and Pumekaman from Orion Team of Princess Jurakorn Science High School Chonburi. With the advisor Mr. Vishen Dunlap, the computer science teacher from Princess Jurakorn Science High School, and supervisor Mr. Subhashavi Pan from National Astronomical Research Institute of Thailand.
The field of exoplanetology is one of the famous fields of study from NASA statistical data. There are around 4,800 exoplanets identified, with an increase of 11 exoplanets detected per year. Recently, the number of cloud observations that utilize the database from the Space Telescope is a new high of over 20,000 times. That is why I motivate us to be a part of the search for exoplanets. Our objective to study the process of exoplanetology to search, detect, and confirm the status of the target. To use this research as a database for higher level research, to inspire young people to be interested and pursue knowledge in astronomy.
Exoplanet is a planet that orbits around its host star in the solar system under the IAU requirements of the planet. The reason astronomers are interested in exoplanets is to study the factors that support the habitability of life. HESS is a telescope under the supervision of NASA for surveillance and signal detection of the exoplanet system. The code name given for object is called TOI, and one of the methods used in detecting is transit photometry method.
The technique involves measuring the dot in starlight caused by those planets whose orbit transit in star. In our perspective, transit observation reveals the size of planet and their orbital period. During an exploration mission by Kepler and K2 Space Telescope, they found a total of 2,600 exoplanets, which is 0.0% of the total. The system has a different inclination of the orbit relative to our perspective. This is one of the limitations inferred from an astronomer who once said that it takes him 2.5 of years to find exoplanets by Subhashavi Avipan.
From NARIS support, we have the opportunity to use the remote sensing robotic telescope in the network. We take the observation in Australia and USA to observe from both hemispheres, then use the robotic telescope at the NARIS website where we can download the image data. Next, we import the image into AstroImageA, the software developed from freeware image, then calibrate the data using calibration frame from the website. Next, import the data again to confirm and click Save in Aperture for process of photometry. With this, we define the scope of the aperture exposure to light with photometry. We then select the TOI and nearby star in the aperture ring. There are two ways of detecting light. First is to use software, and second is to click the image manually. It also has less error compared to software detection, and also solve the rotating telescope problem. When the graph is complete, we inspect the overall characteristic of the graph, then calculate the relative flux from picture tree. Then we can open the fitting mode for additional data. Limb darkening is a phenomenon of unevenly distributed light along the star surface, with the edge being darker caused by unequal density and temperature of the star. We can find limb darkening coefficient by entering the ExoFOB database. Calculate the data for intensity graph, wavelength, and limb darkening coefficient. Then we back to AstroImageA and input the data. In the calculation part, you will see the right side that there are pictures with yellow star and a black point, which is exoplanet. From the effect of limb darkening, we need to integrate the intensity function and average it. We will get the data like this, then we adapt it into equation and into iteration method and least square method into the fundamental value for exoplanet.
We develop a transit using the Markov chain Monte Carlo method that evaluate and filter the value that doesn't meet the requirement, making the end result similar and consistent. In 6 months of more than 15 observations, they target perform Australia and perform USA. According to signal detection, we animate processing, most of data does not depict the transit graph. Therefore, the chart from the main target is strength and also the reference star. In the Apache, however, there are data sets that can detect by detect the presence of the signal, that is TOI 3288.01. It's a from SBO in Australia. In the interpolation method, the depth from the graph is about 3.14% of binet. Orbital size is 7.67 times of the tail star, and inclination of the plane is approximately 89.976 degrees. And lastly, chi square divided by degree of freedom is 1.37, and when it's transit form. In comparison to NARIT, we got similar results in reference to astronomy J because of the low discrepancy of the value set.
In conclusion, we of using the transit fit method, ground remote sensing robotic telescope and transit fit with Markov chain molecular method, we found a possible planetary planet with a depth of 3.14% with a size of 1.08 times of Jupiter radius. The period also tells us that there is low chance of the outcome being white dwarf. Furthermore, from the multiple observations show no indication of high depth shifting from the eclipsing of the star of the binary system.
Lastly, we send the data to NARIT and CASE working group 1 to confirm the signal for the global data indication. We also make an animation for those for visual of the exoplanet orbit. Thank you for your attention. Have a nice day.